Somebody hang me upside down, pinch and twist my nipples, and poke my belly button, because this must be a dream. France is coming. Finally, I am going to freaking melt in this video, guys. Holy shit. I have been so excited for France for so long. When they announced and confirmed that Italy and France would be coming, I got such a huge boner, and Italy finally came to the game, and it was like, yep, that's badass. Now where's France? And, yes, when a couple weeks back, when they, during the freaking Tokyo thing, the CEO announced that there would be a new aviation tech tree coming to the game at some point by the end of the year, which everybody and myself pretty much knew. That's France. And here they are. France is here. I just did a video yesterday, right, with the European Canadian, where he asked me a few questions, and he asked me what I am pretty much most excited for Gaijin to work on right now. And I said France. And then the very next day, France. Holy fucking shit! What the hell? I wanted to play Borderlands for the rest of my life. Now I gotta... Now, let's take a look at exactly what France is going to be like. Well, I'm sure they're not going to show us everything, but you know what I'm saying. They're probably going to do the same thing. I bet it's going to have pre-order packs, and I'll probably buy every single one of them because I'm a fucking retard. Hello? Oh my god, what is that? That is amazing! That is the best aircraft I have ever seen! Guys, listen to me, okay? I am ridiculously excited, okay? Like, I'm more excited than I usually am in videos. I'm sorry if I sound like a complete twat, but you've got to understand, I am so excited for this. I don't know how to explain it. Like, I was super excited when Italy came to the game, because whole new tech tree, whole new nation, that's great. But France is something different. I have this strange connection with France and French aircraft and French tanks, and it's just, please, Gaijin, please. This is amazing. This is the best day of my life. I said, no, listen to me, for fuck's sake. You listen to me, you son of a bitch. I said, a couple weeks ago, when I was talking to somebody, and I think I even said it in one of my videos, I said, damn it, that if Gaijin releases France this year, this would be my favorite year, and in my opinion, the best year for War Thunder. With Italy being released, now France being released, the Chinoo 2 being released, the Hori being released, a whole shitload of really nice events coming out recently, plus, of course, it might even get better because we have the Christmas and holiday events, and we have the freaking anniversary events that will be coming up in just a couple weeks. This is by far, in my opinion, the best year for War Thunder. And that's just me, okay? I know that there's a lot that they've done wrong, but for me, best year. There is nothing that comes close to Borderlands 3. Excuse me, to French aircraft. In 1.73. That's where I got the 3 from. Okay, now let me just... Let's collect ourselves here. Calm down. Breathe. I just woke up. I was trying to fucking get into this. Load up the computer because... Oh, Windows needs to update. So let's take a million years to boot up. Then I load up and someone leaves me a Steam message that says something about... sexy French aircraft, and I'm like, what the fuck? No, you're bullshitting me. And so I go to the internet, Google, and everything fucking freezes, and I have to restart the goddamn thing, only to get just to get it to work to finally record. This plane is badass. Chrome not responding again. I'm pushing my computer too hard here because I didn't let it boot up enough. This thing is going to be mine forever. It will be my favorite biplane. It will be my favorite low-tier biplane again. It will be my favorite low-tier aircraft in the entire game because it looks weird as fuck, and that is amazing. Okay, I'm going to actually be a little bit more serious here. there are aircraft that look like this for the Germans, and I've always wanted those. I don't know what they're called, but I've seen them in games like World of Warplanes, and I actually really like the look of them, and I've wanted Germany to get that plane, whatever that plane is called, for a very long time. I think the Soviets also have one. But I don't think there's any plane in the game like this yet, that France is going to be the first nation to have it, apparently. And it's basically where it's like a biplane, but it doesn't have the lower wing. Its wing is literally attached. It's not even attached to the airframe, or attached to the fuselage. It's literally just extended above, and that's where it hangs. I don't know what that's called. I don't know if there's anything particular that this type of plane is called, but I think they actually look kind of beautiful in a sort of weird, demented way, but they do. Okay, what is this other screenshot here? This is going to be weird as hell. When I was doing some research on some French aircraft, I came across this thing, and I said there's no way Gaijin's going to add that in the game day one, but here we are, and Gaijin's adding that into the game day one. This plane is weird. Okay, it's got a push. I believe it's got two propellers, actually, that it pushes, and it's right. It looks weird, but it's awesome because France. This is fucking amazing. This is fucking amazing, guys. Vive la France. War Thunder rolls out new nation with French aircraft to be released with the next update. Oh, shit. That means it's time to put down Borderlands and start playing nothing but War Thunder for the next 6 weeks, because this is going to be great. We are pleased to announce the release of new 7th nation in War Thunder, France. The update 1.73 will add more than 30 French aircraft to the game, from the fighters of the 30s to multi-role post-war jet models. Holy shit, guys, okay? 30? More than 30? Look, I know that's small, okay, for an entire tech tree. But guess what? Who gives a flying fuck? It's better to have some French aircraft than to not have them at all. Now keep in mind, we do have two French aircraft in the game already, the D-520 and the D-521, which I believe are now collectible aircraft. Well, the D-521's always been collectible, but the D-520 used to be available on the store for purchase, but no longer. I'm pretty sure, pretty confident that at least the D-520 is going to be on the tech tree, the French tech tree. It's kind of like how the Italy's? It's kind of like how the Italians got their Marconi CR-42 Falco as a premium, which was literally the same thing as the Germans at the time. So I'm just going to be guessing that straight up front. Now, I don't know if there's any pre-order packs. I guess we'll find out. Anyways, so here we have creative director of Gaijin Entertainment. Quote, some of the French planes included in Update 1.73 were promising but never entered mass production because of the demands of World War II, so information on them was difficult to source. We spent more than a year in development, searching for various references and painstakingly recreating these rare planes to make War Thunder's French Aviation. We are sure that the pilots of War Thunder will look forward to finally testing these machines in battle. So that's going to already piss off a lot of people because people don't like new shit. But for me, that makes me super bonerific. And the thing that I would really like to point out is that they've been working on this for over a year, and we've kind of known that they've been working on it for over a year. This is what I've tried talking about. Because there's actually recently, very recently, people have said that they're not going to be putting France in the game. And I would respond saying, they've confirmed it, and in the files for quite a while now, there has been quite a few different French aircraft found in the files. There's been things like small light bombers and I think some attackers and some fighters, actually. And I remember looking at these and being like, holy shit, France is coming. Then a year later, here we are, and France is finally coming. This is great. So we've kind of known about this for a while. Okay, so we have... Oh, God, you do... You actually have to purchase this? Now, see, this is why I was saving my money. Well, actually, no, it's not. I was saving my money for the anniversary. But now they go and announce France? What the fuck, guys? This is some bullshit. We'll look at the packs here in a little bit, because that's spoiler. All right, let's see what we have here. Fighter pilots will join the ranks of the French Air Force tree in the Doentine? I don't know how to properly pronounce that. The D-371, which was one of France's first developments away from the old-fashioned biplanes to the faster but still maneuverable monoplanes. While the D-371 did not participate in the battles of World War II, it earned recognition during the Spanish Civil War, where it fought on the Republican side against the nationalist forces, amongst them future Luftwaffe aces. Three variations of this fighter with different machine gun armaments will be available immediately after release, as well as a premium D-371-HS9 with two 20mm cannons. Because let's put a 20mm cannon set up on a fucking reserve plane. That's amazing. Of course, that's not going to be the reserve. So the plane here that they're talking about, we're going to have three of these, I'm assuming, and that's going to be our reserve aircraft. Kind of like how we have the CR-32 and stuff for the Italians. So these are going to be reserve aircraft, but this particular one with the two giant cannons, this is going to be the premium one, which is great. Oh my god, I'm so fucking excited. Okay, stop. Continuing on, during the war, a growing characteristic of French aviation design was the tendency towards universal multi-purpose combat aircraft in the post-war era. This tendency became the standard design philosophy for French jet aircraft. By a successful combination of various offensive and secondary armaments, those aircraft could successfully perform the tasks of both fighters and boomers. A prime example of this philosophy is the ridiculously long named SNCASOSO.8000 Narval? Sure. A highly unusual fighter with a pusher propeller design. This aircraft can excel at a variety of tasks, from intercepting enemy aircraft to supporting ground forces and reconnaissance. In its standard configuration, the SO-8000 features an impressive armament of six 20mm cannons, but if the aircraft is tasked to engage ground targets, it can be further equipped with eight unguided rockets and two bombs. Players who complete special marathon tasks or purchase pre-order bundles in our online shop will be the first who will be able to try out the new French aircraft. If you will pre-order before the release of 1.73, you will receive, as a gift, exclusive in-game titles and decals. So it's exactly like every other time a new tech tree comes out, you either have to beat tasks to gain access, or you have to frickin' win or purchase the bundle packs and then to get access. And there's two bundle packs, just like there was for Italy. And let's take a look. So we have the D-371 HS-9 starter pack, which is $9.99. That is pre-order. In this pack, you get the D-371 aircraft, which will be a Rank 1 French Premium, which will, of course, be available after 1.73 releases. You will get 7 days of premium account, 500 Golden Eagles, and as a pre-order bonus, you will gain the something Knight's Helmet emblem of 15th Fighter Wing, which I guess looks like this, which isn't too bad looking. You also get the Beyond Reproach title, which is pretty badass, and French Planes Closed Beta Access, which doesn't say when that starts. And as for the other advanced pack, this one is $29.99. That's US dollars again. You get the SO-8000 aircraft, which will be a Rank 4 French premium plane, I would assume. Will become available after 1.73, of course. You'll get premium account for 15 days, 1,000 Golden Eagles, a pre-order bonus of some Bombardment Group decal, which isn't that impressive to me, but maybe to you it will be. You also get the Hotshot title, which isn't too bad either. That's kind of nice sounding. And you get closed beta access, of course. PS4 users will be able to purchase these packs after the release of 1.73. The exact date will be announced at a later date. Sorry, PS4 players. Unfortunately, Sony's a bitch. Okay. Somebody, what the hell is going on? Because this is amazing, and I was going to buy the pre-sequel, and now I can't, because France is far... War Thunder always has highest priority when it comes to spending my money. France is going to take everything I have, every single penny. Actually, it's not. Until it comes out, because then I'll buy any premiums they have. Although, considering Italy only has three premiums right now, I think two of them were packs and the other one's just a tier one and you could earn it for free, I doubt that's really going to happen with France. It's probably going to be a similar deal. Though I would like to have some more premium aircraft there, because holy shit. Get ready for loads of dev blogs, guys, over the course of the next weeks, because this is going to be freaking great. This is going to be freaking great. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder video. Please, 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 buy this pack. Support France. They need some love. They need lots of fucking love.